In this video, I'll show you how to set up a Minecraft Bedrock dedicated server with plugins using BDSX on your computer. So first things first, what even is BDSX and why use it? BDSX is a modded version of the Minecraft BDS which supports node.js. This means that it uses the official BDS from Mojang, which includes all the vanilla features but also adds its own, like creating custom commands and other cool stuff. So if you wanna learn more about its features, you should check the GitHub page. But why use BDSX instead of more popular server software like Pocketmine or Nuket? Well, the latter use their own software, whereas BDSX, as I said earlier, is built on the official BDS software. To use this software, you need to be on Windows 11 and have Node.js installed. It is possible to use it on Linux using Wine, but it's unstable and I won't be covering that in this tutorial. Also, be sure to have file extensions enabled in the File Explorer. So, to install Node.js, go to nodejs.org. Pick the long-term support to download. Double-click the downloaded file and simply follow the instructions. Now that it's done, let's get to installing the server. There are two ways to install BDSX. The first one is by directly downloading the zip archive from GitHub. However, if in the future you want to update the server to the latest versions, you have to download once again a zip archive. So if you want easier and automatic updating, I recommend using the second method, which is just Git. To start off, go to the GitHub page of BDSX, which is the second link in the description. When it is done downloading the zip, open it in File Explorer and extract it. So now simply double click on the bdsx.bat file to launch the server. As you can see, it's on the correct version. If you want to easily update your server, use this second method. First off, you'll need Git. Go to this link. Click on Windows and download the latest maintained build. After installing it, create a folder and go to its directory in the Git command interface. Now type git clone as well as the link. When it's done, simply open the bdsx.bat file to launch the server. If you later want to update your server, open once again the git command line at the directory and type git pull. After that, open the update.bat file and your server should be updated. Now that your server is on, go ahead and open Minecraft. In the IP section, put localhost or 127.0.0.1. However, it might not work for some system. If that's the case, go to your BDSX directory, then go to the Bedrock server folder, and here you should find this file. Now open it, and as you can see, it says here that if it doesn't work, you should copy this command and paste it into the command line. Now you might want to open it as an administrator if it doesn't work normally. So now paste the command, and as you can see, it says okay, and you should be able to join the server. Now to configure the server, go to the Bedrock server folder and there you should find the server.properties file. Here it's the name that will appear in the Minecraft server list, so you can set it as you want and you can include color codes, as you can see I set it to green here. So there are many more settings which are pretty much self-explanatory, like the game mode here. And if you'd like to enable the whitelist, you should put this to true and then go to the allow list .json file. You can also add players to your whitelist by writing allow list add, then the nickname in the command line. Finally, if you'd like to add plugins to the server, go back to the original directory. You should see this pluginmanager.bat file. Open it and it should open this interface. Here you can simply select which plugin you want to install. As you can see, I already have some installed. So if I'd like to install this inventory C plugin, I click enter and it should be installed. Perfect. And if you want to put your permissions to operator, just tap copy your nickname and it should add it. Finally, when you're done playing on the server, just type stop and it should save the world and it should close the command line. Since this is a local server, if you want other people to join, they either have to be connected to the same Wi-Fi or connect to your IP. Instead, if you want to have a big server, you need to host it on a hosting service, except very few server hosters support BDSX. But luckily, this video is sponsored by AltCloud, a hosting service for a variety of games, including Minecraft, Java, and Bedrock with BDSX. Furthermore, it has pretty cheap prices compared to most server hosters, and some of the plans provide you not only a Minecraft server, but also a Discord bot and website hosting. They actually let me host the Manhunt event a while ago, and everything went super smoothly. The overall dashboard is very easy to understand. So if you wanna check out AltCloud, it's the first link in the description. And finally, if you wanna check out an alternative to BDSX, click on this video.